Okay, these came out of the garden. This is just a small amount of peppers that we just took out of about two plants. Just to show you the size, the peppers, the cayenne and the jalapeno, not jalapeno, this is the jalapeno. The thick ones there. Those are 2 inches and that's small. Two and a quarter inches. And we got these cayenne and I can't think of the other name of the pepper. It's 5.5 inches long. Got all these other peppers in here. It's two different types of tomatoes here. And this is the green pod okra. That's a small one. That's 1, 2, 3 inches long. Then a lot of times they're 6, 7 inches long when we pull them off, which we cut them up right away and put them in a Ziploc bag and freeze them.
Burgundy ones are the best.
The burgundies are the best. Those are all heirloom. But I just wanted to give you show you how long these have been. These are at least 5.5 to 6 inches, these peppers right here. There's some long ones. And the jalapenos, again, these aren't as big as you see in a store. But they're probably genetically modified to be bigger. But yeah, we're gonna see if we can get these to get a little bit bigger too. These are 2 3/4 inches long for this one here, and that's a small one because there's one or two that's a little bit bigger. I was afraid to let them stay on there, but.
Well, we needed to make some salsa.
We wanna make some homemade salsa. This is one of the green peppers. There's some more big ones out of it. We cut this one in half, got the seeds out of it. Oh no, there's still seeds in here. Now just think about that. Let's just say there's about 50 to 100 seeds in this. Now, each one of those plants is going to put out between 12 to 18, 20 peppers. So these are heirloom, and they're not hybrids. These are where you can grow them forever. And for each seed that brings out a plant, gets another. Just say, let's just use 10. Say there's 500, there's 100 seeds here. Each seed's gonna put out 10, that's 1,000. Now those, you're gonna get 10 seeds, you know, and it just goes on forever. You buy the stuff in the store, or the seeds even from the store, some of them may grow again, but they won't be good quality, and they won't keep being open pollinated. And these are from like 50 plus years of heirloom, what would you call it? Conservation, so that the seeds that they use were from, you know, 50 to 75, 80 years even, some of the seeds on these tomatoes. So you got the best nutrition. I always made a comment that one of my tomatoes gives you at least that of 50 of the tomatoes that are on the market today. Because, you know, people just want to buy it in the store and that's the end of it. Well, pretty soon you're not going to be able to afford to buy it in the store. If you have a small pot or something, try to get a 5-gallon bucket or something, grow you a couple tomato plants or one tomato plant at the very least. Yeah, 5 gallon, grow some peppers, green peppers, whatever kind you want. And just start growing food, because you know what? You're gonna need that. So, I'm not trying to scare people. I've been saying this for like 8, 9 years and people look at me, oh yeah, well, it's to that point now where it's just about here, folks. So, I would really, really highly recommend, I went through Solutions from Science or Heirloom Solutions, I don't recall. I use both, so either site, Heirloom Solutions or Solutions from Science, either one. And get you some seeds. They average around $5 to $6 for a pack. Anywhere from hot ghost peppers, there were 4 or 5 in there in wax paper because they're so hot you can't touch them. I got 2 of them, I think, growing. The other 3, I don't know what happened with, but anyway. You get 50 seeds, you get 100 seeds, sometimes even more than that, depending on the plant. But get the best food you can by growing it yourself. Today's date is the 15th of August. August 15th, 2014. I was just looking over the calendar while I'm filming this. Gosh, I've had a tomato sandwich the first time in my life a few months ago. Last year, actually, my wife made it. And I said, oh, I love them, but I won't have another tomato sandwich unless it's out of my garden. And we've already had a few from in this garden. And that's the best thing you could ever have, I feel. A tomato sandwich. So, homemade doggy treats, wheat flour. Healthy for the dogs and simple.